So guys, tell me something. Have you seen one of these things on your Samsung phone? Stories on lock screen, or promotions on the home screen, or just some useless apps like these? If yes, then guess what? You are the one who enabled all of this, albeit unknowingly, thanks to Samsung's clever tactics. Now, don't get me wrong, Samsung has been launching some nice phones of late. I really like the M series, the M31 is really good, but the fact that they're trying to push ads and promotions is undeniable. It's definitely inspired by Redmi, and while it's technically possible to disable them, the settings are a bit misleading, or rather deceiving, so most people end up using their Samsung phones with ads. In this video, we are gonna see how to set up your brand new Samsung phone the right way for great user experience right from the beginning. You can even follow this guide if you do a factory reset on your existing Samsung phone. My name is Ashwin Sundar. This is Technology Jog. So let's get started. Now, this video is useful if you've bought a budget or a mid-range Samsung phone, because most of these things don't affect flagship Samsung phones like the Galaxy Fold, S20, Note 10, and so on. Now, in my personal experience, whenever I noticed some sort of ads or promotion on a friend's Samsung phone, obviously I would suggest them to disable them, and instantly I get this reply, "Ah, that's a hassle. I'm used to it anyway. It doesn't make a big difference." Well, you might be used to it, but it doesn't change the fact that those things affect the battery life, to an extent at least. So, you've got a brand new phone, you're just turning it on for the first time, or let's say you just factory reset your phone. This is the first thing you see. Just select the language and continue. Now, this is where you'll just glance at everything and just tap agree to all. Unchecking one of them also unchecks the last one, the agree to all thing, and people tend to assume it means we cannot continue, because this is the kind of reaction that all software, all other apps follow. Only if you tick all the necessary boxes, the last one gets ticked. But here, look carefully, those two are just optional. So even though the agree to all box is not ticked, you can still continue to the next page. Not much to do here. You can restore all your data from your previous smartphone if you want. But remember, if your previous phone was a Samsung phone, then you don't have to do this. There is another restore option for you in a couple of minutes. Wi-Fi, quite obvious what you need to do. Sign into your Google account. This is recommended even if it's for an old person, say your grandfather. Don't sign in using any of your Gmail IDs, because later you might get confused as to how to back up and restore without messing up any of your data. So just create a new one for them. It takes like 2 minutes. Next up, screen lock. It's recommended to use a fingerprint scanner if it's available on your phone. Face recognition is generally not as safe as fingerprint scanning. Face recognition just uses software to register and recognize your face, which is not very accurate. There could be false positives at times. In the next page, you'll see a backup option. You can leave it on. It's quite useful in case you want to restore all the apps and settings later on this phone or any other Android phone. But the location has to be turned off. Basically, while using the phone, if you're opening any app that requires your location, let's say Google Maps or Swiggy, it will ask you then and there. And sometimes you get options: allow all the time or allow only while using the app. And you can choose the latter, so the app will use your location data only when it's required. But if you enable location here, it means any app can access your location at any time, which leads to two possible issues. Number one, privacy issues, which is obvious. You don't want to give your location data to all the apps all the time. There are multiple shady apps like Zoom and Facebook that we don't trust. And number two, the battery life takes a huge hit. This is more noticeable in day-to-day life, especially because this feature also scans for Wi-Fi network and nearby devices to find out your location, even if Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are turned off. So yeah, long story short, don't enable it during the initial setup. So this is where the app promotions start. You might want to install some of these apps. Like, as far as I know, most people would want Google Photos and Google Drive, but may not want Google Play Music or movies. But it's not possible to select just a few of them. So I just skip everything and install whatever I want later, because I'll be installing a bunch of apps anyway. Next, we've got a bunch of Samsung apps to choose from. select whatever you want, tap next. Samsung account is not necessary to use a Samsung phone, but it does offer a few things, especially the backup and restore feature that I just spoke about a couple of minutes ago. For example, I backed up the data on my M31, so I can just hit restore here. It restores everything from apps, games, to Wi-Fi settings, alarms, and even the home screen. This is another page where people tend to, you know, just blindly tap next because it says terms and conditions over here, and we subconsciously think we cannot continue if we uncheck it. But please uncheck it. This is probably the worst type of ad on the phone. Here, once again, we get to see Samsung's tactic, trying to push entertainment and offers and apps that we may not even need. Most people would just tap done, but there is actually a hidden option over here. Just disable both. This is what's annoying, right? Like, both options can be easily placed over here, comfortably, but still trying to deceive the user. Next up, we've got some app recommendations. This is on the Galaxy M31, by the way. Once again, there is no skip option. It looks like we have to select one of these app packages to go ahead. But once again, truth is, you can go inside one of these, manually deselect everything, and then tap finish. Easy. Even after doing all this, you still see this widget on the home screen. Anyway, just tap and hold and remove it. Also, during the initial setup, you would have seen this message. Something like unused apps will be put to sleep to save battery life. It just removes apps from the background without your consent. As a result of this, you may lose unsaved progress or data. So it's better to change that. Go to settings, device care, battery, app power management, and disable these. At least adaptive battery must be disabled. Maybe if you notice a huge decrease in the battery life, if it doesn't last as long as you need, then enable one of these or even both. Or you can enable sleep and then choose some exceptions over here. Like whichever app is important, you can prevent them from entering sleep. Like for me, Gmail, Maps, WhatsApp Business are quite important, so those will not be put to sleep. And yeah, remember, we need to install some apps. Certain icons are actually preloaded. You just need to tap them and select Play Store. Yes, select Play Store, don't select the Galaxy Store. Tap Always, because you will never need Galaxy Store, like ever. You'll get a lot of notifications from Galaxy Store, but trust me, you'll never need it. So that's pretty much it. Just a simple thing to follow, but it improves the user experience considerably. I'm sure some of you are experts and you probably didn't find this video helpful, but others who learned something new today, please subscribe to Technology Jock and hit the bell icon to show your support. Thanks for watching. This is Ashwin Sundar, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.